We think about what really happens when we throw a light switch. We expect the light to come on, but what it takes to turn that light on and keep that light on is extraordinary. It's very easy to misunderstand the complexity of the power system. The traditional power system had central generation from large power plants generating enormous amounts of electricity. What we're doing today, of course, is trying to decarbonize and move away from those fuels. And to do that, we need renewable sources of power. The sun, the wind, or the use of waves or rivers to generate hydropower. And so what we're doing is incorporating these sustainable sources into the grid. One of the really most interesting components of what's occurring at the edge of the grid is the concept of a microgrid. For example, a remote community or an island, like Robben Island in South Africa, where the localized balancing of supply and demand allows the island itself to operate as independent for the grid. And so the grid edge is an area that really has an entirely new ecosystem, and they, as we look at the future, become an extremely important building block for the power system of tomorrow.
Ludvika is a very small town in Sweden. It's around 14,000 inhabitants. It feels very homely, and it's a very close community that is gathered around Hitachi Energy as a business. It's part of the identity of the town. HVDC is high voltage direct current, and it's a digitalized way of transmitting energy. HVDC is essential for making offshore wind work. The heart of the HVDC station is the converter valve. You also have a special purpose transformer for HVDC applications, so you can call it that, the lungs of the HVDC station. And then of course you have the HVDC control and protection system, and that is the brain of the HVDC station. And it is completely essential. It's enabling the green energy transition. On top of that, we also have that it's possible to connect different countries with different frequencies, which means that it enables trading, so we can also share the energy more freely.
North Sea Link is currently the longest HVDC cable in the world. We use DC cable because we can go longer distances, we get less losses, and it's a faster process. This system helps reduce the carbon footprint by enabling the transition and the sharing of green energy from the UK to Norway. We've got six transformers on site to step up or step down the current, depending on which way we're flowing. What that's doing is taking away the need of fossil fuels because we can import and export clean energy.
Here in Blyth, when we are sending power across the North Sea Link, we are sending wind power. And similarly, when we are importing power, it's also clean hydropower. So that is really important for us, and hopefully my children's children will remember us for building this project.
Ludvika is one of the plants that do the biggest transformer in Hitachi. Tovåsen was the biggest one with this record in Sweden for the heaviest. It's about 5 meters high. It's almost 400 tons in weight and over 4 meters in width. It was too big to go on rail, so we had to take it by road. Therefore, we had a lot of challenges.
Hitachi Energy is aligning our own 2030 sustainability plan with the United Nations sustainability goals. The actual path we're on, the journey we're on, is a very brief opportunity to be successful. And so the urgency is very real. We have to drive aggressively the adoption of renewable sources of power, which means we have to take advantage of the power of digitalization to enable that adoption, to enable visibility, to enable agility, and enable reliability. Decarbonization is one of the defining activities of our time, and to have a role in driving the decarbonization of the power system is extremely compelling. And of course, that is Hitachi Energy's purpose. We are here to drive a sustainable future for everyone, and it's really hard not to buy into that as an opportunity.
almost jokingly here in Ludvika, this area is called High Voltage Valley. And that is because of the amount of knowledge and competence that we have here in all the fields of electrical engineering. We usually talk about the big advances and pioneers that resided here 100 years ago. We still have these people here today, pioneers within their fields that are currently working to bring a better future for all of humanity.